Hi, my name is Umar Chandar. I am a program manager in the SQL Server team. Today I'm going to show you how you can query HDFS data from SQL Server in a big data cluster. So what I have here is Azure Data Studio. First, I'm going to connect to the SQL Server master instance, which is running inside the big data cluster. Now from here, I can work with both my SQL databases and the data in HDFS. So as you can see here, I have my regular SQL Server databases, and I can also go and browse the data in HDFS. So let's first look at what data I'm going to query. So I have a file here called web click streams. So this file contains data about users, like what items they've purchased, how many times did they click on a particular category, and so on. So let's look at how you can query this data. So I have a notebook here. First, I'm going to set the context of the notebook to the database, so which is sales, as shown in this example. So next, in order to query the data in HDFS, we need to create something called an external data source. So it's an object in the database which tells SQL Server where the HDFS data resides. So in this example, this string here, which starts with SQL HDFS, represents the HDFS data in the big data cluster. So let's first go and create this data source. So after you've created the data source, you need to specify what file format the data source supports and what you're going to query. So in this case, I am going to query data which is residing in Parquet files. So the format of the Parquet file is specified here, right? So let's first go ahead and create this file format object. So now the next step is to create an external table in SQL Server. So this represents the columns which you are going to query from the files, and also the location of the files. So in this case, I am going to query all the data from this directory. So let's quickly see what that contains. So I will expand the directory here. And as you can see, there are three Parquet files here. So now we are going to see how you can query those files from SQL Server. So I've now created an external table object in SQL Server, which points to the directory which contains the Parquet files. First, let's look at some rows from the file. So I run a select query with the top hint, and I see like 10 rows. And this basically previews the rows which are read from those files. So you can also run slightly more complex queries, like just do a count on the number of rows in the table. In this case, I get a result back, and it's about 6 million. Right? So you can also run more advanced queries, like I have a query here which is trying to find the top 10 users with the most clicks. So let's run that query. As you can see here, now you are able to run regular SQL queries against the data in HDFS. So you can basically treat the data in HDFS as if they are local tables in your database. And in this case, I can use the features of SQL Server and the syntax and the functions available in SQL Server to write the query. So as you can see, now I can basically get the results from the files in HDFS. You can also perform other join operations. Like for example, I want to combine the clickstream data with some inventory data, which is also residing in the Parquet files in HDFS, which is actually shown here. So let's run this query. In this case, what we are doing in SQL Server is actually joining two different data sets which are residing in HDFS. And you are able to specify that in a SQL query using the T-SQL syntax, and you can get the results from that query. And in this example, we are actually going to SQL Server, reading the files from HDFS, parsing the data in the files, performing the join operations, and doing additional aggregations in this case, like counting the number of clicks, adding the inventory values, and so on, right? And last but not the least, you can also query this HDFS data and join it with other data sitting in your database. So in this example, you can actually query the Parquet files and join with table in SQL Server. As you can see now, the integration in SQL Server Big Data Cluster makes it very easy for you to join the data from HDFS to other data, either in HDFS or other tables, and get the information very easily. So now you can actually build applications which query data from different data sources very easily. Thank you.